Evening to our brother and sister in our Zoom. Yan. Are we excited na po ba? And we are ready? And we found our comfortable place and chair. Amen? And who among us came from work? Muna na ako doon. I just want to share that I thought tonight that I'm not able to attend and to lead the worship team because due to some the work. So imagine 178 buildings I visit in Marina and JLT in one day, in 6 hours. But I pray that my God, I want to serve you, I want to praise you tonight. May let your will be done. If I can finish this task, so praise God, because around 5:45, I think, I able to go to Alkuri and I call my boss that later the report. I just need to transfer to the Excel sheet, but praise be to God, no, because He's so good. He is always having a way, no? He's giving us, amazing way. Even now, we thought that there's no other way, but if we desire our heart to serve Him, to praise and glorify His name, He will give us a way. Amen? That's why in 1 Thessalonians chapter, I also shared this one last Saturday, no? This is one of my favorite verse, because it says here, always be joyful, never stop praying, be thankful in all circumstances. For this is God's will for you who belongs to Christ Jesus. Amen. We need always to be joyful and never stop praying. Pray ceasingly, sabi na, no? And then always be thankful whatever circumstances, problem, trials in our life may we face. Because when we are still in this earth, we will face this whole problem, trials, and circumstances. Can I invite everyone to stand and let us acknowledge the presence of God and let us pray. Let's bow our head and close our eyes. Hallelujah, Father God in heaven, O God. We thank you, O God, for this wonderful night and for the whole day that you with us, O God, and you are always protecting us whatever we are doing, O God. Lord, we thank you, O God. And Lord, we thank you for the presence in our life, O God. We know, O Lord, that there's a time that for us, in our thoughts, that there's no way, O God. But in your ways, O God, there's always a way, O God. And Lord, we thank you, O God, for the provision that you always given us, O God. And Lord, tonight we ask you, Holy Spirit, to inhabit our heart, O God, as we praise you, O God, as we stand before you, O God. Lord, cleanse our heart, O God, and forgive us for all the things that we've done, O God. Lord, we surrender everything to you, O Lord, and we entrust everything to you, O Lord. Lord, thank you, O God, for the salvation that you've given us, O God. Lord, tonight only your name will be lifted high, O God. And we will adore your name, we will bless your name, O God. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, for giving us, for giving His life. Hallelujah, to be us, for us to be saved. Thank you, Lord. Once again, O Lord, we thank you, O God. We bless your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Let me give a mighty shout to our living God. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, we want to be with you and we want to live with you forever.
Forever. Sorry. You want us to live with you forever. Enjoy, to enjoy this endless life. Eternally in your presence to worship you. Yes, Lord, we worship you, God. So powerful, from the doubts you brought us into your likeness, with your breath, we became a living soul. It rested as this wonderful life. You want us to be with you forever. With you forever. To enjoy, to enjoy this endless life. Eternally in your presence to worship you.
Singing out, oh, 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 turn it out, this
But your love covers all of my sins. So I just want you, Jesus. I just want you, my Lord. So I just want you, Jesus. I just want you.
Sing, I just want you, Jesus.
So I just want you, Jesus. I just want you, my Lord. So I just want you, Jesus. I just want you.
Just want you to know, oh. just want your love. We need you, Lord. Oh, we need you, Lord. Oh, we need you, Lord, in our lives. Oh, we praise you, God, for your goodness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for sacrificing your life, oh God. Hallelujah. We continue to praise you, oh God, our Lord, our Savior. Hallelujah. Words, let's continue to praise our God and in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Stripes, we are healed. By His nail pierced, we're free. By His blood, for we was clean. Now we have the victory. The power of sin. Jesus overcame it all. He has won our freedom. Jesus has won it all.
Jersey,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You have won the victory.
is on high. Our God is risen. He is
Jesus is alive.
He won the victory. He raised on high. Our God is risen. He is alive. He won the victory. He raised on high. Our God is risen. He is alive. He won the victory. He raised on high. Hallelujah, you have won the victory.
Sing hallelujah. Hallelujah,
Jesus. You are the reason, King.
is enough. Your grace is enough for our life. Oh, we praise you, Lord. Oh, we praise you, Jesus. We thank you for your life. We thank you for your love. For leading us from our sin. Making us victorious, O God, and more than conqueror. We thank you, O God. We give you praise. We give you glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, and everybody will say, amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Are we ready?
Yes.
Praise God. Still awake? Hallelujah. Are you blessed today? Why your voice is very slow? You're very serious today. Huh? Okay. So today, what's our topic today?
Walking
with faith in faith. Last time, who is the preacher last time? Do you remember? What is the title of our?
Wake up,
right? So tell your seatmate, wake up.
Wake up.
Okay? Wake up. So what is the first thing that you are doing and did know when you wake up? Huh? You pray after pray? Mobile. After mobile? You are walking, right? You are walking, right? Going to toilet or somewhere, right? So this is connected our topic last time. Amen. Okay, let's stand up for prayer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the worship today. Thank you, Lord, for your presence, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your anointing of the Holy Spirit. We magnify your presence today, Lord. In this congregation, O Lord. Lord, we pray, O Lord, to come here and anoint every one of us, O Lord, that whatever the words that we receive today, O Lord, will be remain in our heart and we can walk according to the faith that you have given to us. Lord, we thank you, Lord, because we believe, O Lord, you are the God of victorious. You are the God who, the King, the rising King, O Lord. Lord, we thank you, your presence. We thank you, Lord, because you are here. We acknowledge your presence in the name of Jesus. And we glorify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. So, last time, Pastor Alito discuss about the wake up, right? The charge of service, right? Amen? So now we are going to learn about how to walk in faith, right? I remember last time when I was in the college, when I was in the graduating stage of my school, in the college, because I was taking a civil engineering course. So the time when our teacher, because we have the data, we have doing our study regarding the how to make our project, the bridge. What we doing is our bridge. We're making bridge, okay? That's our project. So the teacher, the part of that project is the feasibility study. So, under that is there is the pricing. The in accountant is doing this one, okay? The financial report. So, I asked one of my friends to teach me or make me a financial report about my thesis. So, I complete everything, the details is completing. I completed everything. Then, she told me, okay, do this one. It teaches me how to defend, because there is a defend in the thesis, right? You need to defend what you are doing, your design, your financial report. So he teaches me this, that if you're going to defend this one, choose that you will go by your own money. You will not take from the bank, because from the bank, you will have your interest. So if you cannot pay your interest. So this is happening, right? So that's the thing, okay? That during the defense, in the stage of financial report, so we present our report. So this is our report. I have a partner, okay? We have two, but I am the one only defending. Okay, during our defense report in the forum, okay. I discussed with him, this is our report, okay? We will go for our own budget, because we have budget. We will not go for bank loan. So the teachers or the instructors asked us, okay, where is your financial report for bank loan? I told them, I cannot go for bank loan because I have money. I don't want to go for bank loan. So this is the thing, right? You need to defend, right? Because this is the, your teacher is, instructor is teaching you. So that the word, you see the substance because of this word, okay? The substance, okay? So in the defend, the panel of judges told us, if you will not provide the financial report through loan, you will be failed. You will be failed, okay? Both of you. So my friend, my colleagues is crying now, because if we cannot submit, we will be failed. So I told him I cannot do that one, because this is my start, because I have money. So at the long run, my teacher, my advisor, told me also to, okay, Angelus, do the financial report for your grades, okay, for your grades. Maybe you are failed, you will be failed. You cannot pass, you cannot graduate. So what I do, I follow my teacher. So I do four presentations, just to present that we have a financial report through bank loan. So two things, my own accounts and the bank loan. So these things, so I say, you see the story, okay? Because you believe that you depend, you have the budget, and you depend your status, your where you stand, right? Amen. Mm-hmm. So our topic is building our walking in faith. Amen. So it came from in the book of Mark, chapter 9, verse 14 to 29. Let's read. And when he came to the disciples, he saw a great multitude around him, and a scribe disputing with him. Immediately when they saw him, all the people were great amazed, and ran into him, greeting him, and all he asked is, what are you discussing then? Next. Then one of the crowd answered and said, Teacher, I brought you my son, who has a mute spirit. And whenever it seizes him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, gnashes his head, and becomes rigid. So I spoke to your disciple that they should cast it out, but they could not. He answered him and said, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring it to me. Then they brought him to him, and when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed for me to the mountains. So he asked his father, how long has been happening to him? And he said, from childhood. And often he was thrown him both into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes.
Lord,
I believe. Help my unbelief. When Jesus said that the people came and gathered together,
he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to him, Death and not spirit, I command you, come out of it and enter in no more. Then the spirit cried out, Most he greatly, and came out of him. And he came as one dead. So the men said, He is dead. But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. And when he had come into the house, his disciples asked him privately, Why did he not cast it out?
So he said to them, This time can be passed, nothing but prayer and fasting. Okay. So this is the our scripture today. Let's see what is the before this. where is the sitting? Okay, the time when Jesus took John, James, and Peter into that Mount of Transfiguration. So he took these three disciples going to the Mount of Transfigurations. And while they are there, they are amazed, you know, because Jesus Christ showed his glory to the three disciples, and they are amazed, see, because Jesus Christ showed their glory to them, his glory to them. And he's talking with Elijah and Moses that time. So the thing is, after that, the three disciples is amazed about what happening, and he asked, Peter asked to ask Jesus, Rabbi, can we make your house here? You, Elijah and Moses. Okay, but Jesus, when they are going home, are going down to the mountain, he said, don't tell to others until I did not resurrect. Amen? So this is the situation. When they going down into the mountain, because they have 12 disciples, right? So there is 9 disciples who live down the valley. So downside of the mountain. Okay? He brought only the 3 disciples. Okay, that is John, James, and Peter. Okay, so let's go back. Okay. When they come to the disciple, he saw that a great multitude around him, and the scribe disputing with him. So when they arrive in the valley, in the downside of the mountain, there is argument, there is a commotion between the people, and they are surrounded by their disciples, who the 9 disciples live there. Okay, so you know when Jesus when they reach in the valley, right, downside of the mountain, people are surrounded and there is the argument with the disciples, okay? There is a dispute between the disciples and the disciple and the scribes, okay? There is a commotion, there is argument, okay? But when Jesus Christ came there, you know the good thing? No one is talking, no one is speaking, okay? Everyone shout their mouth, okay? Shut them out, right? Okay. You see, in verse 23, okay, Jesus said to him, if you be, okay. So when he was there, what do you think why there is a dispute with the disciple and the scribe? What is this scribe? This is the law expert, okay? Studying about the law, okay? Amen? There is three samples of the disputes, which if we go back in the book of Mark, before this chapter 9, there is some recorded dispute with the scribe and the disciples and Jesus Christ. You see, here the example, you see, and when he came to the disciples, he saw that a great multitude around him and the scribe disputing with him. Immediately when they saw him, all the people were greatly amazed and ran into him, greeted him, and asked the scribe, what are you discussing with him? You know why? Because that time, you know, the scribes is very jealous with Jesus Christ, right? Amen? They are very jealous with Jesus Christ. And they are trying, because Jesus Christ was in the mountain, they are trying to discredit their disciple of Jesus. See? Discredit, because they are very jealous to Jesus Christ, what Jesus Christ has done, right? So, there is the example, I give the example of the dispute of the scribe to Jesus. Number one is, it is in the book of Mark, verse 6 to 7, he forgive the paralytic man, right? You see the paralytic man, when they bring to Jesus, there is no way. Because Jesus is inside the house, and the door is closed because of the multitude of the people. So what they did? They go up on the roof, okay? And they bring the paralytic man down unto the Jesus. And what Jesus did? He forgive, he healed, okay? What is the scribe seeing? See? And some of the scribes were sitting there and reasoning in their heart, why this man speak blasphemy? Like this, who can forgive sins but God alone? Okay? But you know, Jesus Christ is the Son of God, okay? King of Kings. Okay? The next one is in Mark chapter 2, 16, Matthew the tax collector. When Jesus Christ called Matthew, and he called Matthew that he will eat with him, okay? And he bring the tax collector, he bring the sinner, and they eat together, right? When they eat together, and the scribe and Pharisee saw him eating with the tax collectors and sinners, they said to his disciple, how is it that he eats and drinks with tax collectors and sinners? Remember that Jesus Christ came not for the righteous, but for the sinners. Amen? So that's the third one is in chapter 2, Mark chapter 2, the Lord of the Sabbath, right? The Lord of the Sabbath. It was done, now it happened that he went through the green fields on the Sabbath day and he starting to plucking the greens, the greens, okay? the head of the Greeks. And the Pharisees said to him, "Look, why do they do what is not lawful in the Sabbath?" Because Sabbath is wasting time, right? Even in the law, even you cannot bring the needle, only needle, right? But here is plucking the grains, okay? They sow it, okay? The next one is the healing in the Sabbath. The healing in the Sabbath. And he entered in the synagogue again, and the man was there who had withered. So they watched him closely, withered. He would heal him on the Sabbath. So they are observing. They are checking if Jesus Christ will help him in the Sabbath day. Amen? So, and he said to the man who had the withered hand, "Step forward." Then he said to them, "Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do the good or evil? To save life or to kill?" But they keep silent. And when he had looked around with anger and grief by the hardness of their heart, he said to the man, "Stretch out your hands." And he stretched out, and his hands was restored as a whole as the other. And the Pharisees went out, immediately plotted with the Herodians. The Herodians, there is a stuff from the Herodians, okay? And they might destroy him. So this is the type of the example that there is a dispute with Jesus Christ and the scribe, okay? Because they are really very jealous with Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why when they was there in the valley, right? And Jesus Christ was not there, they take that chance to discredit the disciple of Jesus Christ. Okay? To discredit. And the thing is, when the man bring that this boy who impure the spirit, the disciple cannot heal him. So this is the context of their dispute. Amen. Amen. So here, say in verse 17, the boy brought to the disciple, say, "Teacher, I brought you my son who has a mute spirit." The boy has a mute spirit. It means to say that the spirit is enable him to not to speak. Okay? The spirit in him control his body not to speak. So it means there is a deep and dumb spirit. Okay? So if you see this, the manifestation of the dumb and mute spirit is crying, drawn, tearing, blindness, mental illness, air problems, suicidal, foaming at the mouth, seizure, epilepsy, burn, gnashing of teeth, peeling away, and prostration. So that we discussed there, right? Amen? So sometimes there are many spirits that controls our body, not doing the work of God because we are not surrendering to God. Amen? There are many spirits of tardiness, okay? That many spirits that controlling your body. Amen? So that you cannot do the work of God. So here in verse 18, this is the manifestation, seizes him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, gnashing teeth, and become rigid. If you come rigid, right, you cannot move, right? You are not moving. So here, even an unclean spirit defile and bring evil to humanity through physical harm, disability, and sicknesses. So this is the example that the evil spirit that bringing to human through our physical harms, disability, and sicknesses. You know that evil, what the evil is doing, right? It's destroying, killing, right? This is the thing. But evil spirits are not neutral. They are not neutral. They are in your side only. They are part of the demonic crowd led by Satan. You see, imagine that the spirits are not neutral. Okay? They are part of demonic crowd led by Satan. Enemies of the Lord and the people and enemies of the people of God. Unclean spirits promote malice. Okay? This is promote malice, corruption, and immorality in the world and among the humanity. Evil spirits are opposed to the holiness of God. So they are opposing the holiness of God. Okay? Righteousness, goodness, love, and light. Okay? Because light is light is coming to light, right? You cannot come into the dark. If you light, your light is spreading in the dark. Amen? So next. So in Mark 6:7, in verse 18, so I spoke to the disciples that they should cast it out, but they cannot. Okay, they try. The father asked to the disciple to cast it out, but they cannot. They cannot cast it out. The father brought his son to Jesus for the hope. You see, he has hope. He bring his son, even you, if you have son, and your son or your children have this type of sicknesses, have evil in this side, okay? You need to search who can help you, right? The father brought his son to Jesus for the hope that he can help his son. But when he reached in the location, he found that Jesus was not there, but only his disciple. The 9 disciples who lived down the mountain were attended his son. Okay, so this is the only the one who attended the son are the disciples, the 9 disciples, because the 3 disciples at that time was in the mountain with Jesus Christ. The 9 disciples who lived down the mountain were attended with his son. They diagnosed the condition of the boy and tried to cast the demon inside the body of the boy, but it doesn't work. Okay. Remember, in the same book of Mark, when Jesus Christ sent 12 disciples to cast out and heal the sick, right? Remember in the book of Mark also, when Jesus Christ sending the 12 disciples to cast out demons, heal sicknesses. Amen? But the thing, you see, but when the man bring his son, and when the disciple try to cast the demon inside, but there is disappointment. Okay? It's not work. It's not work. Okay? So what do you think the feelings of the father, right? You have your hope, you have your faith, that you will bring your son to Jesus Christ. But the thing is, Jesus Christ is not there, is in the mountain. And the thing and the hope that you found there is the disciple. Okay? The 9 disciples who is staying there. When they are there, okay, they try to cast the demon inside the body of the boy, but nothing, not works. Why do you think? See, let's look in chapter 6. When he called the 12 of himself and began to send them out and give them the power to unclean spirit. The disciple trying to cast, but cannot be. Not work, right? Amen? So what do you think is the feeling of the Father? What do you think some hindrances? The hindrances that to walk in faith. Okay? So here in verse 19, you see that he answered him and said, "O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you?" It sounds like frustration, right? Amen? It sounds like frustration. Remember that Jesus Christ has only 3.5 years to finish his ministry. And he teaching him, his disciple, right? In the mount, you know? He teaching him daily, he coming with him, teaching to the people, teaching with the disciple, right? If you are the one who teaching, your heart will be frustrated, right? Seem like, okay? You say, "Oh, faithless generation, how long shall I be with you?" Okay? So here, Jesus is not pointing out. When he see this one, he's not pointing out the person, right? He pointing out the generation. He never pointing out the disciple. He never pointing out the Pharisee. But he say, "O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you?" Okay? See, take a look in Mark chapter 8:16-21. Why do you think that Jesus said a faithless generation? See, in Mark chapter 8:16-21, they were in the boat, right? They were in the boat. And Jesus is talking with the disciple, okay? He told to the disciple, "Beware of the leaven of the Pharisee." So he asking about, take care about the culture of the Pharisee. Amen? So, and they reasoned themselves, saying, "It is because we have no bread." They are talking about the bread. So Jesus, being aware of it, said to them, "Why do you reason? Because you have no bread? Do you not perceive, not understand? Is your heart still hardened? Having eyes, do not see, and having ears, do not hear. And do you not remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many baskets full of fragment did you take up?" So this is the question that give to the disciple, remembering what Jesus Christ did that time. They said them, "Well," so the disciple answered, "12. And also when I broke," Jesus Christ said again, "And also when I broke the 7 for the 4,000, how many large baskets full of fragments did you take up? So the disciples said, 7. So he said, to them, how is you? You do not understand. You see, sometimes if our teachers, if the pastor is teaching, we forget what is the pastor is teaching us, right? And sometimes they are asking us, okay, what is the topic last? What is the topic last time? We forget, right? Why? Is our heart hard? Is our heart hard? Because we did not perceive to understand. The thing is, you want to go only to sit and listen, but you not internalize, you not think about what is the message to you, right? And we just sitting down and going home, just for present. Hallelujah. Do you think is that the reason? Why very silent? Now you are very silent. Say, okay. Here, you see in Hebrew 11, that's 11 verse 1, you see that now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen, right? Or see, you memorize this one, right? But you need to put in our heart, right? Amen? So faith is now, it's not tomorrow, it's not later time. Either you have faith right now or not at all. You see, faith is now. Okay? Say it, faith is now.
Faith is now.
Remember that, huh? Faith is now. Okay? It's not tomorrow or later time. Either you have faith right now or not at all. Wanting to believe is not enough. Jesus said, I tell you what you ask in prayer, believe that you will receive now and I will be yours. It will be yours. Okay? Faith is the substance that things that you hope for, right? Faith has a substance. It is not a blind leap. It is not jumping into the dark place not knowing where to land. You think, if you think that if you want to jump in this building and you don't know how where you land, right? Amen? This is the thing, right? Faith is the substance that things that you hope for. Faith as a substance. It is not the blind leap, it is not jumping into the very darkness, not knowing where to land. You should know where you jump, okay? Where you fall down, okay? It is not the substance of it is faith, God Himself. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. Remember that. Faith is the evidence not seen. Amen? So what is the first thing that hindrance our faith? Okay? Number one is fear. Okay? Fear. Okay? God's word may be hindered by fear. Fear is not from God. It is from the devil, okay? For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. See? It's a power, love, and a sound mind. This is God has given us. When we experience fear, we are being attacked by the evil. The remedy is the presence of Jesus Christ. Okay? When we experience prayer, we are being attacked by evil. The remedy is Jesus Christ. You remember when Peter, when Peter, you remember Peter denial 3 times, right? And the thing is, Jesus, when Jesus Christ was brought by the soldier for questioning in the court, and that time is Peter is following Jesus Christ, but he keep distance. Okay, he keep distance. When the lady or the lady came to her and asked, "You are the with Jesus Christ, right?" But he denied. You know why he denied? Because Jesus Christ is not with her, with him. Okay? There is a distance, you see? The distance between Jesus Christ and Peter. When again he came, another one came to Peter and asked, "You are with him, right?" But he denied. Okay? Because Jesus Christ is not in his presence. The third time, he denied again. Okay? If God is not in your presence, is not in you, is not with us, do you think we have faith? Amen? So we need the presence of God in us. Okay. So Jesus told them to bring, okay, in verse 20, he said, Jesus told them to bring the boy. Then they brought him, and when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed, foaming out the mouth. The father says that his son passes again by the impure spirit in his, and bring him fear. So this is the one, because you know, this boy is a boy, right? And when he has the impure spirit in him, in his childhood, so 8 years already in him, the process is in years. So the Bible says that his son passes again by the impure spirit in which bring him fear through his experience with the disciple. The Lord assure us of His presence to take away our fears. Okay? You see in Hebrews 13:6 that, "So may we boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear." Okay? The next one, the hindrance is by walking in faith is experience. Amen? Experience. So when Jesus asked his father, how long has this been happening to him? And he said, from childhood. So if more than a year, the father experiencing the same manifestation in the body of his son, right? Being the father, it's difficult for him to see his son in this condition. Even us, if we experience, if our son or our children have this fever, we cannot stay in our place, right? We need to, time to time, we need to check, right? Because we love our son. We love our children. Amen? The same thing, this is the condition, the feeling of the father of the boy. Okay? So, by the experience, by his experience, when he brought to the disciple, the problem here is when he brought to the disciple, right? And the disciple cannot cast out. So, what do you feel? You hopeless, right? And experiencing to bring his son to the disciple cast nothing and fear half his friend that surround him, make us also doubt, affecting his full trust and confidence. Okay. But when Jesus initiated to minister to him, asking question, you see, he asked the question, initiating, he asked the question, how long this is happening, right? He initiated, Jesus Christ initiating question. It's not because Jesus Christ want more information. It's not because he don't know. We know that God is all-knowing God. Man, this is that thing, that time, you know. I think this is not logical to us, but a perfect timing. A perfect timing. Okay? We know that God now know everything in us, our thoughts, our hearts, and our action, so that he will come closer to Jesus. When he experienced the presence of God, he said, but if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Of course, God can do everything and nothing impossible with God. He's God, right? The one who created heaven and earth. He created everything. Amen? See the attitude of the Father when he faced prostration, when he faced hope. Okay? He asked Jesus, if you can help, if you can do. In verse 23, Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible him to believe. Okay? Then Jesus Christ, he returned back to him. Okay? He asked question, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believe. It's possible to him who believe. So upon hearing the word of God, immediately the Father cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief. Do you see that the words of the Father? The situations when Jesus Christ entered in his life. You know, this is the deep declaration of faith with this man. See? When you are in the deep side of your life, in the deepest life of your life, you will experience God in your life. Because there is no other thing, other one who can help you, but only God. You see, he's drawing, he initiating the conversations with this Father to return back to him. Okay? Maybe you say, I cannot do today, but he said, come with me. I have something to do, come with me. This is Jesus Christ having to draw to him. Everyone who is in the deepest situation of his life, God is ministering to you to come near to God. Come closer to God. Okay? God is faithful. God is faithful. God is a loving God. Amen? So disregarding experience and he believed the word. As a result, his son was healed. Obedience to the word does not depend on our previous experience. You have to believe the word regardless of your experience. We need to believe, okay? So, the next one, the third one is feelings. Feelings, okay? Faith always involves obedience. It means obedience to the very specific word we hear, even if it is contrary to what we feel. Okay? Feelings can weaken your faith and oftentimes bring fear. Faith means trusting, obeying the word rather than feelings. Okay? Amen? So this is the our hindrances walking with faith. The first one is fear, and second experience and feelings. Amen? Understand? So the next one is, so the third one is how we walk in faith. How we walk in faith. How do you walk in faith? So here, the first one is hear the words. So faith comes by hearing the words. Now, how did faith come to the father of the boy? The father heard Jesus say, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. Okay? The father received faith when he heard the word of Jesus Christ, because the word of God is so powerful. And that very moment he received the word of faith also hand. You receive faith the moment you hear God speak his word to you. See in Romans 10:17, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. If you hear and hear, it comes with, right? If you every day you hear this one, you will develop your faith in you. Amen? So number two, letter B is obey the word. Okay, obey the word. The father obeyed the word of Jesus right away. See, in Hebrews 11:1, now faith is defined as right now. Like faith, obedience must be right now. Genuine faith requires immediate obedience. Amen? Immediately the father of the child cried out and said, and tears, Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief. Amen? Faith is always tested. The Bible tells us to fix our eyes on Jesus, not in our problems. Remember that. Because sometimes if we have problems in life, if all our problems come, and it's not ending problems, right? You are not focusing in God anymore. You are focusing in your problems. How to solve your problems. But remember this, Jesus Christ can do everything. Just give to Him. You see, if every day, you see, if you are carrying 1 gallon of water, okay, 1 gallon of water, and the next day, along the way, you take another 1 gallon, so it's become heavy, right? And the next step, you have another gallon, so it's become heavy. The same thing, if you have problems in life. If you have problems in life, give it to Jesus. Give it to the Lord. Every day, exercise your faith. Give it to Jesus every day. If you experience difficulties in your work, give it to the Lord. You see, if today you experience, give it to the Lord. You have experienced problem today. Oh Lord, I give it to you. Please help me. So you release your burden. The next day, if you have encountered problem again in your life, oh Lord, this problem again, can you take this problem See? You see the situation? If you every day release your problems in life, you will not put the burden in your heart. Right? You release. Do not make your heart like a bank. Only deposit. But release it. Amen? So, next one is look unto Jesus. See, we must look unto Jesus when we experience problems. Looking unto Jesus means casting all your problems upon Him because He cares for you. See how beautiful, how beautiful in the ears to hear this word. Jesus Christ cares for you. Jesus Christ cares for us. Amen? So how do we look unto Jesus? Jesus and the Word of God are the same. When our faith is being tested, we must continue to meditate, trust, accept, and obey the Word of God. See? Remember this one. When our faith is being tested, we must continue to meditate, trust, accept, and obey the Word of God. Okay? Amen? So, next, see, in verse 25, see, when Jesus said the people coming running together, He rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to it, "Deep and dumb spirit, I command you, come out him and enter him no more." Then the spirit cried out, convulsed him, raised him, and come out him. And he became as one dead. So that means it, he is dead. But Jesus Christ took him by the hands and lift him up. And he arose. And when he had come into the house, his disciples asked him privately. So when they came in the house, the disciple asked him, why could we cannot cast it out? So he said to them, this can be come out by nothing but prayer and fasting. So it can be done only by prayer and fasting. Who among you attended the intercession prayer? Who among you attended the IP training? There is silence again. Huh? Anybody attended? Who does not attend? So, he said that, Jesus said that only prayer and fasting. Amen? So, see here, from MacArthur, see, prayer is the highway that takes to the power of God. See? Prayer is the highway, okay? Highway, the way that takes to the power of God, okay? Prayer is your connection to God, okay? This is our connection to God. This is our communication to God. If you are not prayerful, how we can communicate God? Amen? How we can intercede, stand in the gap. Okay? It's only through prayers. Right? Only through prayers. Prayer is the highway that takes to the power of God. So, see like this light. this bulb. Do you think this bulb is not connected with a switch? It will bring light? Cannot be, right? So our life, our spiritual life, should always connect it with God. What Bible say? Bible say that you are the vine and we are the branches. Okay? We cannot do anything if we are not connecting with God, right? We cannot do by ourselves. We cannot do by our strength, our power. We don't have power. Only God has power. So being connected with God. Okay? You know, this type of the topic what we discuss, the situations, we need because there is a demon, right? We need to be exposed. We need to be ready. You need to be battled. Warfare. This is warfare. Warfare. Okay? Because it's a spirit, right? We know that the spirit is powerful also, right? Powerful also. But you see, here, let's come back. You see, in 25, when Jesus saw that the people came running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, seeing. If deep and dumb spirit, I command you, come out him and enter no more. And the spirit cried out, convulsion him in greatly, and come out to him, and he became one dead. See, Jesus Christ has authority. Okay? Jesus Christ has authority. He's a powerful. He's a powerful God. See? When Jesus Christ commands this evil spirit come out, he cannot do but to come out because of the power of God. See? Come out! But evil spirit cannot have no power with Jesus Christ. We can. And when Jesus Christ say come out, he cannot do nothing but to come out. Amen? So here, so that's why it's very important for us to always ready, right? Because devil is only surround, okay? He's waiting. He's waiting, okay? So you see in Colossians 2:3, having this arm, principalities of power, he made public spectacles of them, triumphing over them in it. You see, Jesus Christ giving us the power to cast demon, even in the disciple, they're giving us to cast demon. Even as if you are Jesus in Christ in you, you can cast also demons. You can heal the sick. You can do many things in Jesus Christ in you. Amen? See here in Ephesians 6:10-13. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against the flesh and blood, but against the principality, against the powers, against the ruler of the darkness of this age, against the spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Amen? See? God is giving us the power, okay? The sword, the word of God. Okay? the helmet of salvation. Remember this. Be strong in faith with God. Always in the presence of God in your life. Because the moment when you receive Jesus Christ, He gives you the power to become the children of God. Okay? He gives you the power to become the children of God. We are have our inheritance with God. Amen? That's why when He sent the 12 disciples, He gave them the power to cast demons, to heal the sick. Right? Amen? You still awake? So, summary. This spirit between the scribe and the disciple hindrance to walk in faith. Walking in faith. Now, conclusion. Our title, walking in faith, right? So we have to be dependent in God. Do not depend in yourself. Depend in God. Okay? Be dependent in God. Hallelujah! Amen. To God be the glory. Let's start. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you praise. We honor you. We bless your name in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the words today, Lord. Lord, we pray, O Lord, to build more our faith on you, Lord, that we can stand against the work of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Lord, build us more our faith and trust in you, to depend on you 100% in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for this day, O Lord. We glorify your name. We magnify your name. We pray that everyone, that this word will remain in every heart, O Lord. And I can walk faithfully in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We give you glory. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.